Mr. Chairman, members of the governing board. I'm Gary Foster, project manager of the NRTD Development Planning Program, and I'm here to present an informational update on the status and cost provisions of the program. Due to the droughts in the early 50s, the Florida legislature enacted the first regulations dealing with free-flowing wells, requiring working valves or caps to be installed on flowing wells, and a few years later, adopting additional legislation dealing with plugging of artesian wells. In 1972, the Florida legislature established the five water management districts, and the rules governing the abandoned artesian wells were enforced by the districts through the Florida Department of Environmental Regulation. In 1983, the Water Quality Assurance Act was enacted, calling for all known abandoned artesian wells to be plugged. The district began funding the program and seeking to share costs with local governments and homeowners. Reimbursement guidelines. The residential and homeowners at 50% of the cost per well to a maximum of $600 per well. Commercial, industrial, agricultural, excluding public water supply utility wells, 50% of the cost per well. Public sector and government, 50% of the cost per well. Government conservation lands, no cost to the managing or owning jurisdiction. The diagram illustrates the problems that occur with failing abandoned artesian wells and why they should be plugged. As you can see, A, continuous flow at the surface, the failing well, and B, water from the lower aquifer leaks into the superficial and intermediate aquifers, and C, inter-aquifer flow of lesser quality water moving upward and contaminating the freshwater water in the upper portion of the same aquifer. Here we have a brief video represents our largest well plugging event of this year. Our safety officer, David Seeloff, is conducting a safety briefing before working commenced. The contractors are removing a leaking flange of a 10-inch well with a maximum potential flow of 800 gallons per minute. Their crew is attempting to pump out the water, allowing them to install the header. As you can see, some of the water issues you might encounter with the flow rate of 800 gallons per minute. The crew is now installing the header, giving the control of the well to the contractors. They begin logging the well to determine open hole diameter, total well depth, and other aquifer parameters that are useful information when plugging the well. The work crew begins pumping three truckloads totaling 21 cubic yards of cement into the well, plugging it up to the surface. This chart illustrates the total wells plugged per county. As you can see in Brevard and Indian River, artesian conditions consist throughout these counties. And in Seminole County, it's mainly around river and spring areas. Moving to the right side of the chart, you see Putnam, Clay, Duval, and St. John's, where those conditions exist along the river. This graph represents the yearly maximum potential flow conserved per year with a total maximum potential flow conserved of 697.5 MGD. In order to put this into perspective, this number is 33 times the current annual allocation of the city of Melbourne at 20.7 MGD and 5 times the current allocation for one of our largest utilities, JEA, at 133.5 MGD. The large fluctuations in NGD per year is due to changes in funding and staffing. Well plugging program benefits: aquifer protection, water supply conservation, water quality and hydrologic data source, reduction of associated health risk and hazards. I would encourage everyone to check out the article and put a cork in it and streamlines on page 1. Thank you very much. Any questions?